Hello, friends. We are now very much approaching the end of our Agents of Deterioration journey. There are only two more videos after this. Like, oh man, it's been crazy how fast this all went, but I hope you guys have been getting some great info and value out of these videos. So let's just keep on going. Today we're talking about temperature, or more so, incorrect temperature, because there's always a temperature, but if the temperature is too hot or too cold, that's where we can get into some trouble with our museum or archaeological collections. Let's get into it. Incorrect temperature can mean one of three things. The temperature is too high, the temperature is too low, or the temperature fluctuates too much or too quickly. Different types of materials react to various temperatures in different ways, so you need to look at your collection to really see what the best mode of attack is for tackling this issue. Temperatures that are too high can cause physical, chemical, or biological damage to materials, and the hotter the temperature, the faster the rate of decay. So if we know that, we can then figure out that a lower temperature therefore means a lower rate of decay. Materials that are very sensitive to higher heat are acidic paper, like newsprint or mass market paperbacks. Old films will also shrink in heat. Materials based on cellulose and early plastics can also yellow and become very brittle, which would then cause more cracking. Some acrylic paints and canvas supports are also very susceptible to higher temperatures. A really scary thing that can happen if the temperature is too high is that canvas oil paintings that are lined with a wax resin can actually detach from the lining. Of course, it's not like an instant thing, but it's still a scary process. A lot of different types of glues can also soften under higher temperatures, and they could be glues either from the original manufacturing or glues used during conservation treatments. Perloid B72, for example, which is like the conservation glue, has a glass transition temperature of 36 degrees Celsius. A glass transition temperature is essentially the point where it can start to soften and become a lot weaker. And 36 degrees Celsius, it's hot, but it's not that hot. Materials that aren't so susceptible to higher temperatures would be things like oil paint, regular paper, cotton, and wood. That being said, they still degrade over time, and lower temperatures do help in prolonging their rate of decay. Now, when I mean higher temperatures, I'm not talking hundreds of degrees Celsius. Even a temperature as high as 30 degrees Celsius can drastically reduce the lifetime of an object. But the good news is, if you reduce the temperature by as little as 5 degrees, you can essentially double the lifespan of an object. Yep, you heard me, double. So if a sensitive object has a lifetime of about 7 years in a room of 30 degrees, if you lower the temperature to 25 degrees, now it can be preserved for 14 years. This is some serious preservation magic right here. If we do some very basic math, that means if you store the object at 0 degrees, it'll survive for 600 years, which is pretty decent. Of course, you can't keep an object at 0 degrees forever because cold storage can be quite expensive and using all that energy is just not so great for the environment, but you can see how museums and other institutions can use temperature to their benefit in order to prolong the lifespan of their materials. You might find that museums could be a little bit chilly, but never too uncomfortable. And this is exactly why. Museums try to strike that balance of visitor comfort and object safety. So from everything that I've just said, it seems like the lower the temperature, the better, right? Well, sort of. If the temperature is too low for certain materials, a lot of physical stresses can form. So that means they can become harder, more brittle, and much more easier to crack. In these lower temperatures, paintings can become more vulnerable to physical forces, which is the first agent of deterioration that we talked about. Metal can also crack, and materials like leather and rubber that are supposed to be a lot more flexible, they'll become a lot more brittle. So extremes are bad. We know this. Extremes are bad in everything about life. So the final temperature that we need to be careful of is fluctuating temperature. We know from all of our science classes back in elementary school that heat expands and cold contracts. So imagine if the temperature in a room is always fluctuating, getting hotter and colder multiple times throughout the day. That's a lot of expansion and contraction, which can lead to a lot of stress being put on an object. If temperature fluctuations happen too quickly, the object isn't able to respond evenly and adjust to its new environment. And as I said before, it causes physical stress and it will create cracking or it'll just make the materials unstable. This one isn't super dramatic because a lot of materials can handle some temperature change, but it's in everyone's best interest to keep temperatures stable. The biggest thing with fluctuation in temperature is the coinciding fluctuation in relative humidity. We are going to be talking about relative humidity in the next video, but it's essentially the moisture that's in the air. Some materials are very susceptible to moisture, so this fluctuation is just bad news bears for them. So now that we know what the risks are with each type of incorrect temperature, let's get into how we can control this and protect our objects as best as we can. Some best practices in regards to temperature control are to keep artifacts out of direct sunlight where you can get warmer patches. Make sure you're installing a reliable heating system in your museum or storage space. Use insulation to avoid dramatic fluctuations from outside. And always monitor your temperature to make sure that it's stable. Stability is the most important factor. Even if your temperature is a few degrees too hot or too cold, if it's consistent and stable, then you have a lot of things that you can occupy your day worrying about. It's also a good idea to really look at the materials your objects are made out of and try to store them accordingly. If you have a cold storage room, take advantage of it for your most vulnerable collections. So there you have it, friends, our 8th agent of deterioration. If you liked that video, go ahead and smash that like button down below. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel so you don't miss the last 2 agents of deterioration that are coming out very, very, very soon. As I said earlier, the next video is going to be talking about relative humidity. And that's a very, very important one when you're dealing with incorrect temperature. So these 2 agents really are sort of a team. They work together, so it's one of those things that you really need to be watching both in order to make sure that you understand it all. Big thanks to all of my patrons on Patreon. If you want to become a part of the Patreon community, the link to that is just in my description down below. Here are all of my socials, and I'll see you guys in 3 days. Stay dirty, my friends.